Well, we haven't forgotten you.
I don't know how we'll win this yet, but we will. Even if it kills me.
Well, you've already died once, and that didn't slow you down. But let's not tempt fate.
Yeah, let's...
Keep yourself safe, Shepard.
You too, sir.
We'll talk again soon. Anderson out.
Shepard out. Engage. Alliance funding, 12,500 credits. How's our stuff doing here? I haven't checked this lately. New alien. This is all new stuff. Terminus fleet. The Terminus fleet is an assortment of mercenary vessels and pirate ships bound together by little more than a common geography and a fear of the Reapers. Despite this volatile mix, the fleet seems to be functioning as one under the leadership of criminal warlord Arya Taloke. Updated. The Blood Pack's mercenaries have been compared to floods, wildfires, and other calamities. It recruits Krogan and Vorcha, preferably those with no regard for collateral damage. On the rare occasion when brute force is insufficient, the Blood Pack is willing to deploy weapons of mass destruction normally banned in Citadel space. Updated. The Eclipse Corporation specializes in smart security solutions, developing tactics around surgical strikes, sabotage, and electronic warfare. These mercenaries are supported by a sizable army of combat mechs and rely heavily on tech for support in combat. Rachni workers. Wait, hit that by mistake. Not at all mindless insects, the Rachni are capable of feats of engineering comparable with any sentient species. While initially greeted with suspicion, the Rachni workers dispatched to the Crucible have integrated into the project smoothly. Excellent. They work especially well on tasks that benefit from group work, and senior Crucible staff members are learning to trust the Rachni with more complex problems. Spectre Unit. Spectres are the left hand of the Citadel, enforcing laws and stopping crimes with galactic repercussions. While Spectres usually work alone, the Reaper threat gave cause for these extraordinary agents to assemble in an elite unit capable of operating in enemy territory without backup. Spectre John Dumbau, while not their official leader, is the group's spokesperson. He has passed on important intelligence gathered by the unit to Hackett and the 5th Fleet. Hanar and Drell forces. The Hanar have sent their warships to engage the Reapers to repay Commander Shepard for saving their homeworld. Though the Navy is relatively small, the Hanar have also provided the services of their best Drell combat specialists. When did I necessarily save their homeworld? They are accomplished spies, saboteurs, and assassins, trained at an extremely young age. While the Hanar are normally loath to send trusted allies into open warfare, excuse me, these are desperate times. I need a drink. I saved their homeworld by stopping that one Hanar from sending a virus, I believe, into their satellites or something. He who regards the works of the Enkindlers with despair, name is the soul name. Omega Ezo Horde. As promised, Arya has started transporting her Ezo supplies to the Alliance. Excellent. Though the initial delivery was somewhat hampered by Alliance security's unease in dealing with a group that most think of as space pirates, the transfer of resources is now ongoing. To facilitate the process, a new freight company flying under the Omega flag has been founded. The Omega Coalition of Cargo Transporters is a ragtag group that has nonetheless proven to be unerringly successful in both the swiftness of their deliveries and the security of its cargo. All this new stuff I'm just going to read. Omega Raiding Fleet. Though comprised of a disparate range of ships, the Omega Rum Fleet has proven itself to the Alliance in every way that counts. Their first engagement occurred during orientation, when the Alliance ships they were meeting were overwhelmed by a Reaper attack. Rum was told to avoid the rendezvous point, but they instead followed Fusion, their flagship, straight into combat to save the doomed ships. The Alliance ships were saved, and Rum, recklessly led by a cheerfully ruthless Captain Jarral, has since been detailed to the most troubled Reaper fronts, and each time has helped turn the tide. Rum landing parties also have a sterling, if somewhat bloodthirsty, reputation, particularly when up against Cerberus Phantoms. Phantoms in particular, huh? Okay, Alliance. The System's Alliance represents humanity's economic, political, and military reach throughout the galaxy. Its naval forces are led by Admiral Stephen Hackett. Alien races that were once content to stay on the fringes of galactic politics are now stepping up to provide whatever is needed to win this war. Cool. Alright, new. This might be new, but we landed on it. That makes any sense, so I'll read it. The Alliance Engineering Corps cuts roads through mountains and builds bases on asteroids. While the bulk of the AEC has active wartime duties, their brightest are helping build a device of Prothean origin recovered on Mars. Due to the staggering amount of raw materials required, the AEC has been given unprecedented emergency funding for any Alliance resources that will not interfere with the deployment of troops. 103rd Marine Division. The old saying, every Marine is a rifleman, still holds true in the Alliance. Every Marine enlistee, from clerk to sniper, goes through a period of infantry training. As a result, the 103rd Marine Division is Earth's largest collection of Special Forces soldiers. Officers from notable battles, such as the Skellion Blitz and the First Contact War, run harsh training exercises in a variety of environments, insisting the Marines be prepared to storm any breach on any planet. This training has been useful in the Reaper War, as the 103rd can be fighting in an Arctic desert 1 week, crawling through jungles the next. Updated. Biotic students from the Grissom Academy have joined the 103rd Marine Division as a support unit. The students focus their biotics into barriers that shield the Marines and help control the flow of the battlefield. Yes, grudgingly. They really didn't want to do that. They didn't want to just make barriers, but that keeps them safe. And that was a decision that, Shepard made. Alliance First Fleet. The First Fleet was stationed near the Charon Relay when the Reapers invaded the Sol system. By the time Admiral Hackett issued the order to retreat, its size, once the largest in the Alliance Navy, had been cut in half. Commanding Admiral Ines Lindholm made the painful decision to use a tenth of the fleet's remaining vessels as cover so the remainder could escape. Her gamble paid off as the First Fleet limped out of the relay to rally with the rest of the Alliance forces on the run. Updated. Thanks to Arius Hacker, the Cerberus files located in General Petrovsky's afterlife headquarters were retrieved mostly intact. The encryption ciphers are complex, but Aria has her top technicians scraping the data for anything that may be of use to the Alliance. Key intel on Cerberus activities and Alliance theaters has already been found, providing the forces fighting in those areas a tactical edge. In more heavily encrypted files, valuable threads are emerging that could uncover top-secret Cerberus operations. Kaylee Sanders. See, I'm reading all this. I'm not sure if just the updated is the new stuff. So I'm just reading it all. I'm pretty sure this stuff wasn't here, actually, these main entries. First Lieutenant Kaylee Sanders joined Grissom Academy's board of directors when she gave up her military career. When the Cerberus raid on the Academy was thwarted by Commander Shepard, Sanders joined with Alliance engineers working to recreate the Prothean device found on Mars. Her past work as a systems technician, specifically studying synthetic intelligence, has helped decode some of the complex feedback systems that control the weapon's energy output. Updated. Some of Grissom Academy's more technically minded students were saved by Cerberus from Commander Shepard. They've met up with Sanders, contributing their brain power to some of the problems she's been tackling. And updated. David Archer is another refugee from Grissom Academy working on a device. Despite his youth, Archer's theories on interstellar cross-modulation have won him respect with the project scientists. Yay! Jack, formerly known as Subject Zero, may be the most talented biotic of her time. After helping Shepard destroy the Collectors, she was offered a teaching position at Grissom Academy by the Alliance. Accepting the position for reasons of her own, Jack continued to hone her skills while training her students. Grissom Board of Directors member Kaylee Sanders has vouched for Jack's energetic, if unorthodox, teaching style. Impressed with the inroads made with the children under the Rogue Biotics' care. I don't know how that came about, that she was offered a teaching position. Doesn't seem a very likely candidate for that. Alright. Alliance 5th Fleet. The 5th Fleet became famous across the galaxy after spearheading Alliance forces at the Battle of the Citadel. It was guarding Arcturus Station when the Reapers attacked. After a bloody and desperate battle, Admiral Hackett gave the order to retreat, sacrificing the entirety of the Alliance 2nd Fleet to give the 3rd and 5th the chance to escape. The 5th Fleet engineers are busy repairing its damaged vessels, grimly anticipating a return to Earth in revenge against the Reapers. Updated. A pair of entrepreneurs was persuaded to switch from creating financial programs to advanced weapon-targeting VIs and to sell them to the Alliance just above cost. Kasumi Goto. And all this stuff is not updated. Kasumi Goto is wanted in over a dozen systems for sabotage, hacking, theft, and a laundry list of other crimes. The Alliance is willing to overlook Goto's indiscretions in exchange for her help with the Crucible. In addition to her expertise with electronic security systems, Goto can acquire important technology through... acquire important technology thought lost or stuck deep in enemy territory. No one dares ask how she acquires these items. I thought that was a typo or something. Crucible. Completing the Crucible device will require entire systems of resources and skilled workers, as well as the galaxy's brightest scientists. Javelin missile launchers. Hold on a second. Developed by the Alliance, Javelin missiles release dark energy upon impact. This creates devastating space-time disruptions, magnifying warp fields that strip away a target's molecular bonds. Even the strongest kinetic barriers will eventually collapse after multiple impacts from these rockets. Alliance R&D commandeered several colony factories and now produces enough Javelin missile launchers for all dreadnoughts in the Allied fleet. Ex-Cerberus. As the elusive man's methods become more extreme, skilled operatives abandon Cerberus. They have offered to help stop the Reapers any way they can. Cerberus research data. Well, I don't know if we have any ex-Cerberus people yet, but we have data. Data liberated from a Cerberus research lab includes reports on the composition and strengths of various Reaper units. Alliance scientists are fact-checking the information, but it appears to be genuine, so Alliance military VIs can use it to strategize against the Reapers' ground forces. Krogan. The Krogan clans have agreed to throw their considerable might against the Reapers. Their shock troops are aggressive, relentless, and recklessly brave. We have Grunt, the perfect Krogan. I'm so glad he's still alive. I can't believe they did that to us, torturing us, thinking he was going to die. The perfect Krogan was thrown into the world without a past, a name, or a cause. After destroying the collectors with Commander Shepard, Grunt returned to Duchanka to learn what it meant to be Krogan. After countless arguments and brawls, the clans have granted Grunt a modicum of acceptance. Tough, wary, and cunning, the young Krogan knows this experience will pay off now that it's time to fight the Reaper's forces. Aralak Company. Okay, so we have him and his company as assets. Cool. Ancient Tuchankan legends claim that the Aralak Wastes, named after the system's star, were where the first warrior died in battle. Aralak Company is made up of Krogan from all over Tuchanka, each chosen for their strength, ferocity, and fighting experience. No Krogan community would dream of sending anything less than the finest warriors to represent their clan. The honor of who's to be chosen for the company has started more than one brawl. Updated. Aralak Company is led by Grunt, a genetically engineered perfect soldier who fought the Collectors with Commander Shepard. While young, the Krogan has survived such brutal battles that the older warriors of his group have begrudgingly accepted his command. Updated. Grunt was appointed representative of Clan Erdnot, in addition to becoming head of Aralak Company, a political appointment not lost on the other clans. Grunt sees this new position as the first large victory he has won on his own. The respect of his people is difficult to come by. Updated. Wave after wave of Rachni overwhelmed the Aralak Company on Utuku. While fighting an impressive enemy to the death is considered an honorable end for the Krogan, Arilak Company has effectively been wiped out. So how do we have them as assets? If they're wiped out. Turian. The threat of Turian firepower once kept entire armies in check. Now the hierarchy's vast fleets and numerous soldiers are needed to win the largest war in galactic history. Turian 79th Flotilla. The Turian 79th Flotilla distinguished itself during the Krogan rebellions when they clashed with Krogan warships above Dejeris. The 79th sacrificed themselves in great numbers to bring down Krogan vessels attacking the colony. Centuries later, the flotilla continues to rely on speed and stealth to harass the enemy. They run interference, divert fire, and make bombing runs on enemy ground units until anti-air defenses manage to target them. Alright, so that's that. That's all these. And then our total military strength is 1858. Readiness rating is 50%. That doesn't change, at least not yet. Effective military strength. I'm not sure what this line is. Is the minimum at the line, or is the minimum here? We have to fill up the minimum. So I'm not sure what the line is, though. More information. Your total military strength is now 1858. Galactic readiness is sitting at 50%. Allied forces are overwhelmed by Reapers on multiple fronts and taking heavy casualties. Troops assisting in a final push will have a strength of 924. Chances of success are very poor. Well, we have to get... So a total and effective. Oh, I see. Because we only have... We don't have readiness, so we only have half of our military strength. Because we have the strength, but it's not ready. We did look at all this. Alright, let's go around and talk to people.
Yes, Commander?
Nothing new. Alright.
That's all.
Of course, Commander.
I'm sure there'll be something new with Rex, though. Did we finish his quest?
Need something, Shepard?
No?
What's the situation back on T'Chanka?
I'm still getting scattered reports of Reaper forces arriving. Something big is brewing. I won't let those things take T'Chanka. Not when we're about to cure the Genophage. My people have had enough bad luck in our time.
That's it for now, Rex. Let's get back to work.
Anytime.
Anytime. Alright. Guess we can see what else.
Well, Reapers don't have colonies. Neither do servers. If they did, we could drop an asteroid on them.
Yeah, it's just gonna check up with everybody.
Commander, Cerberus is attacking civilians on Benning. We've been asked to help evacuate the planet.
Oh, really? Took care of one quest, added another. In fact, two more then. Oh, this is a new priority T'Chanka. Cerberus abduction. Cerberus is attacking civilians on Benning. Land on Benning and provide protection while civilians are evacuated. Seems important. Priority T'Chanka. The Genophage cure is a success, but it must be synthesized and dispersed across all of T'Chanka using the Shroud Tower. Land on T'Chanka and get Eve safely to the tower. Yeah, not doing that yet. Basically gonna get everything squared away before we move on to that. Everything else.
You know, my lab studied the Ragnai. Long distance communication with no time lag, the ability to control workers. And at close range, the Queen can even speak through dead or dying members of other species.
Glad they're on our side.
If we can develop instant long-range communication without quantum entanglement, maybe when this war is over.
Yeah. First survive, then communicate.
Commander?
Any new emails? Yeah, we do have a new one, and she didn't even tell us. Yeah, she was busy telling us about the other thing. From Liara. Shepard, I've been working on something I'd like to show you. Can we meet in your quarters when you have a moment? Liara. Now, what's funny is that I know they can't say... My character's name is Brittany Shepard. So I know it's unrealistic for her to be saying Brittany. But at least write it. That's just a string of characters. You can throw that in there. I will most certainly go to her quarters and check out what's going on. First, let me check in with Edie and Joker.
The Turians will hold. Pound for pound, they're the best fighting force in the galaxy.
True.
Pound for pound is irrelevant, given the significantly higher mass of Reaper forces overall.
Well,
that's why we're bringing in the Krogan.
The Krogan might be the best fighting force in the galaxy.
How's Grunt? Our little tank baby's all grown up, huh?
Apparently, yep. He'll be on his feet and killing again in no time.
Well, you learn from the best, Commander.
That's
every
clear.
Time he incinerates someone with a shotgun and does that little laugh, he'll think of you. He says it was Rachni down there?
Yeah.
Yep.
I thought they were on our side after you saved the Queen on Novaria.
It wasn't her fault. She got captured. She's with us now.
Until the next time the Reapers sing a sour yellow note of whatever.
It's the Reapers, man.
Commander.
Hello?
Shepard, I had a question about human behavior.
Why is it you never have questions about Asari behavior or Turian behavior?
I tried asking Liara questions about the Asari bonding process.
Oh.
She said I do not guard the secrets of the Normandy's crew carefully enough for her to entrust me with such private information. The Asari word she used translates as blabbermouth. She has become a more
awesome
private person since becoming the Shadow Broker.
Tell me about it.
Yeah, kinda.
Hello, Shepard.
What's your question about human behavior? You ever asked a question?
Hello, Shepard.
I mean, humans or other... I mean, you're basically an organic computer. How can you get distracted enough to forget to ask me the question? Alright, let's...
Chief Engineer Adams would like to speak with you down in engineering.
Okay. What was I seeing on this side? Was I looking at that? Across the way? I guess so. Alright, so we gotta check in with some people. So yeah, looks like more of a full... I don't feed these, right? Because I got, like, feeding them forever. They won't die or whatever. Paid for that. Intercom?
Liara, you had something you wanted to discuss in my cabin?
Yes. Oh. I'll be right up.
Oh, my cabin. Aw. It's not flowers, but it'll have to do.
Come on in.
Thank you. Could we sit?
Yes.
I've been thinking about the knowledge we gathered on the Reapers, and how easily it could be lost again. So, I put a plan in motion to preserve things for the future.
Oh? What's this? Hologram recording
thing? What's this? A record of the galaxy. Information on the Reapers, relays, different cultures, and blueprints of the Crucible.
Oh.
But there's one entry I wanted your opinion on.
Which one?
I thought we were going to record a video or something.
I'd be honored to have your input. How would you like history to remember you?
Huh. You sure this thing will last? Through everything?
50,000 years is a long time for a computer to sit around.
Please, I was an archaeologist. I know what I'm doing.
True.
I'm encasing these records in time capsules and seeding copies on multiple planets. And while it's not foolproof, the VI I'm installing has every translation and linguistics program I could find.
So it's an information guide, like Vigil on Ilos?
Yes. I've been preparing it for some time.
And it will be a privilege to guide the future discoverers of these records. Have you decided what you would like Dr. Tassoni to write in your entry, Commander?
I'd like her to side.
You know me well enough to fill in the blanks, Liara.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'd like it to be your call.
All right. Let's begin with the fact that Earth's most famous officer was born and raised in space.
Spacer.
The commander was also a powerful biotic, nearly unstoppable when she charged into a fight. She was a soldier and a leader, one who made peace where she could.
I didn't charge much, though.
And it was a privilege to know her.
Aww.
Careful this doesn't sound like a diary.
I can't help myself. You're a good friend, Shepard.
More than that. So are you.
You've been there for me too, Liara.
No, I haven't. I wish I could have joined you back on Ilium.
You're here now.
You made up for it.
Well, aww. I suppose I did just write your name in the stars.
Plus two reputation. And just like that, she's gone! Damn it. Well, I had no idea I'd be using this intercom thing. I thought it was going to her quarters. I guess I wasn't paying attention. See, now it's not a... it's a private terminal. Yeah, I don't need that. I have to accept just to get out of it. Okay. Well, that was cool. Let's go to Shuttle Bay.